I need your help with the Lennox furnace error code E228.
That is the error code for unable to perform successful pressure switch calibration.
I didn't even know the switches could be calibrated.
Most furnaces don't do that, only inform you if the pressure switch is stuck open or closed.
So what do I do about a Lennox furnace error E228?
The manual says to retry after 5 minutes.
It isn't like I'm doing the calibration myself.
Reset the furnace or even reboot it by turning off the power and back on. It will perform the pressure switch calibration as it boots up.
It seems to have already tried that.
Then check the vent system for blockages that prevent proper airflow.
It wasn't like a bird's nest landed in there or a colony of dust bunnies is breeding in the vents.
If that were the case, you need an exterminator, not an HVAC service call. But the error can come up if the air filters are really clogged and the system can't make sense of it.
I had the sense to check the filters, and they aren't dark with soot, so that isn't the problem.
I recommended checking airflow constrictions first because that is easiest to fix. The pressure switch wiring connections are harder.
Yeah, replacing the pressure switch typically requires a pro, unlike replacing a flame sensor.
It could also be a loose wire to the pressure switch or corrosion on the switch.
That could give the unit the intermittent signals that cause it to be unable to calibrate.
Before it gives you the E228 error, it will tell you the controller is calibrating the furnace pressure switches. Give it enough cycles, and it may actually succeed.
If in doubt, reboot is only supposed to be done once or twice.
Sometimes the root cause is dirt on the pressure switches that prevent it from working right until cleaned up.
Instead of worrying about airflow, I may just need to blow a hair dryer on the switch to make sure all the debris is removed.
That will help if high humidity in the air is shorting things out, too.
Then the long-term solution is a dehumidifier.
Or you need to empty the drain pan under the furnace. Make sure the drain tube is unblocked and the filter isn't so clogged the furnace can't move air fast enough to keep its components dry.
And then I get to reboot it again so the thing gets past the error, and have to reboot it anyway if it is a control board error.